Hello fellas, I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to have two battles with Judas. I have quite some replays of this vehicle, and today for me is very hard day. Why so? I was working outside for quite a lot of time. We rented the cabin, or however it's called, which is fitting next to the car, right? You are putting that on the hook and you are driving with it, however it's called. It's a truck or however, right? And I was working all day outside moving stuff, so today no stream. My apologies, I'm a disgusting person. But look at the bright side, today I will work on the YouTube videos. And that's what we are doing. By the way, this TVP is making a mistake. And look, the 277, we are doing the standard player idea, and we are going in front to take a position which is in Echo Foxtrot 3-2, but oh boy, those TVPs had a good plan. By the way, you are going to have some fun, sir. Yes, it's not over. I will touch you gently once again. This TVP is running, but I'm not going to let him go. Or maybe I will. I'm trying to get the shot. TVP is dropping down. Hello there, 140. It's okay, I'm not complaining, fellas. If we have chance to shoot someone, skill is happen. 140 noticed that he made a mistake, and we are sending him back to the garage, and clickers are clicking. And keep that in mind, fellas. The botched Arta hit us before, right? Oh, you dirty clicker. Oh, where you are? Aha, you are sitting right there. Roger that. Okay, remember this botched Arta which was clicking us, and look what we are doing. We are loading high explosives already. For what? For blind shots. So I think botched Arta is somewhere over there, fellas. Let's see here. Yes, it is a wrong one. Damn it, fellas, I missed. I did not hit my shot successfully. Okay, maybe that other clicker is somewhere around this area too. Well, you never know. You need to blind shot. Look for a splash. Look for a splash. And where is splash, fellas? There is no splash. Let's try our luck once again. And oh boy. It's just amazing, fellas. The feeling which you are having for blind-shotting two sky shits. It is so damn good. It's so satisfying. And it's one of the best feelings in World of Tanks without any doubts whatsoever, okay? That was so beautiful. And I'm so happy about this. Anyways, battle is not over, but let's get real, fellas. We are winning this battle. They lost sky shits, and now it is a matter of the time when they are going to get effed. By the way, their light was never ever spotted, and our light is dominating the hill, so yeah. And by the way, remember the same TVP which in the start of the battle was a vroom 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 going like this? Well, the same TVP is stuck right there. But in the same time, it's quite bad thing for us because he is blocking us from doing more things here. But it's okay. I believe we are going to have a good side shots on the IS-7 or 277, but apparently those guys is dying and not much what we can do right there. I'm trying to find a good shot, but you know, Ruski armor, it's not that easy to penetrate in the huge distance, and I should show the hits earlier. Anyways, TVP, yes, I remember you from the first moment of the game. What we are doing here, we are trying to spot almighty Jack Pizdas, which is playing in the back right there. We have a hit loaded right now, and it doesn't matter which tank I'm going to shoot. And in the same time, there is E4 in the corner, so I'm saying hello for E4. I decided to go for the lower plate instead of going for cupola. Why not? I can afford it. Aiming for the lower plate to almighty Jack Piston, we are penetrating him. Fellas, in this battle they had no team, and why I decided to share this battle with you, fellas? I decided to share this battle especially for those two blind shots. Oh boy, it was just amazing, and everyone of you knows that. Everyone of you should know this feeling, and it's just amazing. It's just beautiful, right? Anyways, speaking of the TVP and riding, woo! Just like this, fellas. And I'm not only one which is going to ride this TVP. I know it sounds weird. I had quite some fun jumping on this guy, and in this battle, my mood was on top for a it was just going through the roof. In this game for sure, right, fellas? And now this tier 5 here is just simply getting he's taking one for the team. Our T62 is jumping down, and our Super Conqueror. And I'm saying, what's up, man? Having fun? That's how this game was looking like. I know it's not typical game, but the most important thing why I shared this game with you fellas was those blind shots on Artas, right? And yeah, it's as a game, fellas, this is the battle in the World of Tanks which you are expecting in 2019. I'm not even joking. Majority of the times one team is winning very easily, majority of the times a team is losing very easily. And now you saw one side of the story, right? Now you need to see another side of the story, okay? So stay tuned. And fellas, we are back. We have a Siegfried line, we have very, very nice matchmaking, but remember what I said in the end of the last game? Yeah, a lot of teams... In 2019, a lot of teams are like, you are winning very easily or you are losing very easily. So, in this game, fellas, we will try to fight for our ass. You will see everything in the first moments of the game. You will see what our team is doing. And how we are starting this battle. We are starting this battle from the typical hold down position over there, right? It's just amazing. You can punish people which is going like this, because people is doing that, people is playing over there, and you can get quite some use of this position, and I just love it. For example, this lightweight went way too aggressively. He's not paying attention at me, and I'm simply smacking him for 475 in the side like nothing, fellas. And in this position especially, fellas, you are simply waiting until enemies is going to make one or another mistake. I am feeling like those tank destroyers over there, fellas, they should be able to snipe people over there, so I don't really think they need my help or something. Plus, they have some sniper schnitzels in the back, so hopefully everything will go fine. What I noticed that the Sterva sniper schnitzel is sitting over there, and there is quite some people which is playing in the middle. So what we are doing, guys, we are taking middle ourselves, and we are trying to punish enemies for crossing, for doing something, and this tank is amazing. Aka best gun depression owner so far in the game, and it's just crazy, fellas. So, let's see what enemies are going to do, right? There is Vaka over there, there is two T-34s, and what I'm currently waiting till those guys will peek. Since we have a side shot right there, why not to shoot the UDES? Oh boy, I thought I'm going to hit the E100, but luckily that was not the case, so I'm super happy. Anyways, another side shot into this guy. Bounce. Two bounces in row for UDES. RNG, unfortunately, is not treating us very, very well. And remember what did I said about the losing games, right? Score 0-5 in 2 minutes of the battle. How it's even possible, I don't know, but apparently 5 guys died in the first 2 minutes. Well, hashtag never lucky. I'm not surrendering. Our score idea is definitely not the best. We have 1,300 only, but it's okay. We are just starting, and look at this Lynx. Lynx is going like a Ferrari. 80-15, turn around. Turn around, man. Lynx is trying to gangbang the Arta. 80-15, turn around, sir. Look, there is Lynx in the back. 80-15, he have no Fs given. 80-15, sir. Look around you, Arta is getting gangbanged. Look, help that Arta. So that's how every single of us is losing the games. Fellas, if you are playing the game with this kind of map, no wonder why you can't see shit. So If it's possible for you, make map as big as possible and you can see everything. You can see even if fly will fly around next to you, you are going to hear it and you are going to see it. So tip number one, make a maxi map maxi, okay? Anyways. Look at how we are working this ridgeline right here. We are exposing ourselves just a tiny touch, just a little bit. And with those heat ammunition, with this heat ammunition, we can go through this type 5 heavy light hot knife through the butter, right? So look at this beauty. I'm peeking for his cupola, I'm smacking his cupola, and he have no chance to do anything for us unless luck is going to be on his side, and he's going to smack me in the face with his high explosives. But once again, it is a good trade. I am not complaining to get to take one for the team for 400 with a high explosive and to keep shitting on them. I would say it is a good trade. That was RNG fellas right there. This Vaka survived this situation, which was quite sad for us. But what can you do? Aiming for the lower plate because we are having hits. So far 5000 dealt, and from this moment RNG is starting to shitting on us. Okay, that was not very good aim, and unfortunately ball breaker managed to survive this. Well, what can you do? Nothing. Another one into the ass, low roll right here, and that's why we did not kill the ball breaker, which is very very sad. But it's okay, we still can get quite some things done right here. And look at this situation, fellas. 5 to 11 in 5 minutes of the game. It's crazy, right? But in the same time, this is the situation which every single of you are experiencing. The battles is very, very unequal, and not much what we can do about this. Anyways, we are trying to support this Tie 5 heavy, and RNG is smiling on us. We are getting 470 into the face of the Tie 5 heavy, and he is taking one for the team. So now, fellas, look, Esterva is going for us while saying no, sir, things like this is not working for a tank destroyer. If you want to play like this, Bobject is the line for you, sir, and this is not a joke. Esterva is dying for his stupidity since he made a huge mistake, right? And Skill is still smiling. Skill is having over 7000 already, and Skill is saying, give me more, give me more. And fellas, I am not paying too much. The same ball breaker. The same fellas, ball breaker. You lucky, lucky man. Actually, that was Maushen, I apologize. Well, close enough. Ball breaker, Maushen, they have one difference. And that one difference is tier, right? That's it. Anyways, we finished this guy off, and now situation is 1 versus 5, sorry, but in the same time they have a clicker tracked us. T34 bounced our side, and Udes finished us off. Anyways, it doesn't matter, fellas. That kind of, I tried to fight for my ass, okay? I tried to do everything what I could in this situation, but I did not manage to win the battle. And you know what? I was not, and I am not sad by any means after games like this, when I know I did everything properly. And for example, fellas, you are playing with, for example, Esterva Tank Destroyer. You are sitting in the back as you belong and as you supposed to. And you are seeing that your team is melting, right? After that, you are doing one or two shots and you are dying too. And you know what? You should not be ashamed of that, and you should not be sad, because some battles are simply not winnable. You can have the best tank in the world of tanks. If you can have everything, but you are simply not winning, because this game, after all, is a team game, right? One person cannot fight against the 15, because you are going to get gang-banged, and it's going to be your problem, if I can say so, right? So, my advice for every single of you, don't be sad, fellas, for losing games. Don't be stressed out for losing the games. Look at everything from the different angle and say for yourself, I did everything what I could do the best. Or if it was not the case, if you noticed the mistake, which you did, don't do the same mistake once again, or just try to not to do that mistake which you did and which you figured out yourself, okay? That was your daily dose of skill, fellas. I hope you enjoyed this one. And today I am going to work on a lot of YouTube videos. I can tell you that you are going to see the live gameplay in the near future with probably Jack Pizda, because I fucked up in the Tech 3 showcase, right? And it was not very, very nice, so we are going to fix it. I will show you a couple of games, 2-3 games. You are going to see more likely 1-to-1 gameplay, live gameplay, since I have quite some time today. And I will pre-make a lot of replays with Judas, because I have 6 more very, very good battles, and I'm going to talk about this tank or about the other things, okay? Or explain the strategy which I was doing. Anyways, that was your daily dose of skill, fellas. I hope you enjoyed this one, and see you very, very soon. Peace.